Greetings. This video is part 10 in a series. I'm examining and reviewing all of the verses which Islam tries to claim refer to Muhammad. I challenge you Muslims to listen honestly. I have been proving that the people who sell Islam have been making bad, desperate claims. I've told you why Islam is desperate and must make such provably false claims. The question for you, O Muslim, is do you place any value on the truth? Do you, O Muslim, have any respect for Almighty God? Does anything in your heart ever yearn and long and wish and hope to be certain of the truth? Well, I challenge you Muslims to listen honestly, and if you do, you will know the truth by the end of this series. I challenge you to try and prove me wrong. And when you cannot prove me wrong, accept the fact what I am saying is right. In the Gospels, the primary claim Islam attempts to make to insert Muhammad is to claim he is the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. I am completely serious. Islam, which knows nothing about the Holy Spirit, tries to claim Muhammad is the Holy Spirit. Well, I think the first and best approach to help you understand the truth is simply to review all the verses Jesus said about the Comforter. Let's begin. I'm going to start in John 14. The first use of the word Comforter is in 14:16, but to establish context, I'm going to start in 14:11. John 14:11. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very works' sake. 14:12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believes on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you. Continue down a few verses, and you come to John 14:24. He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings. And the word which you hear is not mine, but the Father's which sent me. These things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If you loved me, you would rejoice, because I said I go unto my Father, for my Father is greater than I. I highlighted the final words because these are often ripped out of context by Islam. Those passages introduce the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. Nothing can be known about the Holy Spirit of God if God does not reveal it. So here the Son of God begins to teach and train the disciples. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very works' sake. Jesus is revealing how deep his relationship with God is. Jesus says God the Father is inside him, inside Jesus. And Jesus says he is inside God the Father. And Jesus says if his words are not convincing, believe him because of the demonstrated power of God. Believe me for the very works' sake. This is the fundamental proof that God sent Jesus. And the reason Jews and Christians demanded proof from Muhammad, which he never produced. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believes on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Over and over, Jesus calls God his Father. And when the Son of God is glorified, this brings glory to Almighty God. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. This is Jesus claiming to answer prayers. I will do it. If you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Pray the Father, meaning ask, request, petition, intercede. But here are the two words Islam tries to hang on to. Another Comforter. And this is one of those fascinating hypocrisies of Islam. Islam will try to claim another means another like Jesus, whereas when they claim Mohammed in Deuteronomy 18:18, Islam argues Jesus is not like Mohammed and Moses. Here, Islam argues Mohammed is like Jesus and is another comforter, just like Jesus. Can you see the error and inconsistency in their desperate claims? Jesus is not finished describing this another comforter. But notice, he, the comforter, may abide, meaning live or dwell, with you forever. That he may abide with you forever. Islam will offer a twist and claim that this means Muhammad's words. But that raises a problem because it is Islam admitting the Quran is Muhammad's words and not Allah's. It is sufficient to say that taken literally, this eternal presence cannot be met by a man. And that is one clear element of the description of the Comforter which Muhammad cannot fulfill. Even the Spirit of Truth. The first phrase causes problems for Islam because Jesus said spirit and not prophet. The word spirit comes from the Greek pneuma, and this cannot be prophet. But if you look, and not even too hard, you will find Didat changing the word spirit into the word prophet to try and change Jesus' words to fitting Muhammad.
They say the Comforter is the Holy Ghost. So they'll ask you, is Muhammad a ghost? He says, no. So it can't be Muhammad. I says, now what is that Greek word for ghost in your language? Greek word. It's pneuma. Pneuma means spirit. Wherever it suits you, you translate that word, P-N-E-U-M-A, pneuma. A spirit, when it suits you, you translate it as ghost. When you talk about spirit, you can have it fitting Muhammad. But when you say ghost, like a spook, it's very difficult to say Muhammad is a spook.
Whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. Wow, it gets worse and worse for Muhammad. Jesus said the world could not see the Comforter. Remember, this is Jesus the prophet and Son of God talking here. Jesus said the world could not see the Comforter. So I'm asking Muslims, was Muhammad too small to see? Was Muhammad invisible? Did he have a cloak of invisibility with his magic carpet? Because Jesus, good old Prophet Jesus, Isa ibn Allah, said the Comforter could not be seen. This is another damning point against Muhammad ever fitting this description. But it's about to get a whole lot worse. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you. Beep, beep, back up the truck. But you, the disciples, know him, already know him. This is Jesus describing the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, to the disciples. And Jesus says the disciples already know the Comforter 600 years before Muhammad is a blood clot. This is another fact that absolutely damns Islam's fraudulent claim that Muhammad is the Comforter. And how do the disciples know the Comforter, the Holy Ghost? But you know him, for he dwelleth with you. The Holy Spirit was living with them already. And here is the core phrase, and he shall be in you, and shall be in you. He is with you now. When I sent you out, he went with you. You know him already. But when I leave and I send him, it will be different. Shall be is a future tense, and shall be in you. This is Jesus explaining what will be different when Jesus sends the Comforter in the near future. The Comforter will come and live in you forever. He will never leave again. In fact, when the Holy Spirit comes, he will prove you are adopted sons of God. Romans 8:15, for you have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Galatians 4:6, and because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying, Abba, Father. The Comforter is the Holy Spirit of God and is also one with God. And Christians, I want you to pause and think about this next verse. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. I will come to you. Jesus just said he would send the Comforter to comfort us, one might rightly infer. And then Jesus says he will come unto us. Well, I've managed to cover John 14, and it is clear it is impossible for this to be Mohammed. One, Jesus said the Comforter was known to the disciples. Neither Mohammed nor his words could be known to the disciples 600 years before Mohammed existed. Two, Jesus said the Comforter would live with them eternally, forever. Mohammed could not live eternally with the disciples, so this damns the claim that Mohammed is the Comforter. I'm not yet even focusing on the fact Jesus promised the Comforter to the disciples who lived 600 years before Mohammed. But that is probably the most damning flaw in the claim Mohammed is the Comforter. 3. Jesus said the Comforter would live in the disciples. Impossible for Mohammed to fill, and impossible for Islam to create a rational argument against. That does not mean they won't try, because Islam has no regard for facts, logic, truth, or God. I've had Mohammedans claim this is all allegorical for the word of Mohammed, the Quran. And there is literally nothing you can say to cut through the blindness which envelops such a person. You can only pray and bind the demon of blindness and the demon of Islam who has bound them. 4. Remember the author of the Quran claimed that the unlearned prophet who could not read and could not write could be found mentioned in the gospel? But John 14 does not mention another prophet. It mentions an eternal Comforter who could and would live in the disciples. John 14 does not mean a prophet, unlearned or otherwise. It does not even use the words unlearned or read or write. So there really are two groups of people on the earth. People looking to correctly understand the things they read, and people so programmed to defend Muhammad they ignore words, facts, logic, and the truth himself. Don't you be the latter and wind up in hell. In part 11, I'll try to get through John 15 and 16. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.